36. Figure 1 shows a block oscillating on a spring. The block is to the right of its equilibrium position, x equals 0, and moving to the right. The two vectors indicate the spring force Fs and the frictional force F acting on the block at that point. Figure 2 shows the block after it has reached its maximum displacement and returned to the same point. Which of the following indicates features in the figures that support claims as to whether the spring force and the friction are conservative forces? A. Since the magnitude of both forces is the same in both figures, they are both conservative forces. There is no relationship between relative magnitudes of forces to the fact that they are conservative or non-conservative. B. Since the magnitude of both forces is the same in both figures, they are both non-conservative forces. The same reasoning can be applied here. C. Since the spring force always points toward the equilibrium and the frictional force always points against motion, they are both conservative forces. It is true that the spring force is conservative and that it always points to equilibrium. However, there is no relationship between pointing against motion and being conservative. D. Since the spring force always points toward the equilibrium and the frictional force always points against motion, the spring force is a non-conservative force and the frictional force is a conservative force. A force that points always against motion will always produce a negative work. Therefore, the total work will never be zero over a closed path, and the force cannot be conservative. E. Since the spring force always points toward equilibrium, and the frictional force always points against motion, the spring force is a conservative force, and the frictional force is a non-conservative force. Indeed, the work done by the spring force will be zero over a closed path, and the work done by friction will always be non-zero, regardless of the path being closed. Our option is E. 37.